program for the names of the soloists that are there. And please make sure that you applaud for them after they finish their solo. There's nothing wrong with that for jazz band to do that. Also, I want you to understand that none of these solos these kids are doing are written solos. These are all improv. They're making it up as they go. So what a scary thing to do as a high school kid. And they have done such an amazing job. I'm so proud of them. Next piece is Alone Together.
Thank you.
first two pieces we performed were from our concert assessment held last month at Van Buren, where they received superior rating from all the judges. The last two pieces will be pieces we've worked on since then. This, as I talk to the kids, I explain this next piece to them. Hopefully they're lucky enough sometime during their educational careers to find a teacher or mentor who really inspires them, kind of urges them on and gives them the path. I had one of those in my undergrad at the University of Kentucky, and he recently just passed away this last August from his battle with cancer. His wife had this piece commissioned in his honor, so we're going to play it tonight. It's called Home.
Thank you. Thank you. everybody. My name is Bryce McCaslin, and I'm a senior here in our band, and I'm a clarinet player. Our next piece, we would like to steer you in a different sound. Our last piece was a little aggressive and a little hard-hitting. We want to do something slow, emotional, that speaks into your presence, into your soul. Our next piece is by John Mackey, and it's titled Some Treasures Are Heavy With Human Tears. This piece exists in distraction and meditation on grief. In breaking the work in this way, the music transcends, elegizing a singularly horrific event, and instead provides an artistic representation of how we cope with all tragedies, both that are intensely personal and those that are communal. It explores a wide range of emotions from denial to shock, fear, and anguish before finally finding a complete peace. I do recommend, if you do feel okay with music, you might tear up a little bit, so if you have purses and you have tissues in them, I would have those handy.
Thank you. everyone. My name is Michael Farrell, and I'm a junior trumpet player for our band. Tonight's last selection is Of Sailors and Whales by Dr. Francis Macbeth. Of Sailors and Whales is a multi-movement work based on the scenes from the book Moby Dick. It was commissioned by and is dedicated to the California Band Directors Association, Incorporated, and was premiered in February of 1990 by the California All-State Band, conducted by the composer. The work is also subdedicated to Robert Lyman White, a retired commander for the United States Navy, who went to sea as a simple sailor. Call me Ishmael. I go to sea as a simple sailor, right before the mast, plumb down into the forecastle, aloft there to the royal masthead. I am tormented with an everlasting itch for things of note. I still love to sail forbidden seas and land on our various coasts. For these reasons, the whaling voyage was welcome. The great floodgates of the wonder world swung open. There floated in my inmost soul endless possessions of the whale, and one grand hooded phantom like a snowy hill in the sky. If you would please hold your applause, because this is a multi-movement piece until the last movement. Thank you.
Thank you. Zayden Kilgour. I'm a sophomore and a trombone player. Our next movement will be Queequeg. Queequeg's father was a high chief, a king. His uncle, a high priest. There was excellent blood in his veins, royal stuff. It was quite plain that he must be some abominable savage, but Queequeg was a creature in a transitory state, neither caterpillar nor butterfly. Savage though he was, and hideously marred about the face, his countenance yet had something in it. Through all his unearthly tattooings, and in his large, deep eyes, fiery black and bold, there seemed tokens of a spirit that would dare a thousand devils.
Good evening. I'm Tanner Gill, and I'm a senior trumpet player. This next movement is entitled Father Maple. There was a low rumbling of heavy seaweeds among the benches, and all was quiet again, and every eye was on the preacher. Father Maple rose, and in prolonged solemn tones, like the continued tolling of a bell in a ship that is foundering at sea in a fog, in such tones, he commenced reading the following hymn.
Thank you. Holly Smith, and I'm a junior in percussion, and our last and final movement of this song is called Ahab. As I leveled my glance toward the taffrail, foreboding shivers ran over me. Captain Ahab stood on his quarter deck. So powerfully did the whole grim aspect of Ahab affect me that for the first few moments, I hardly noticed the barbaric white leg upon which he partly stood.